Okay, 50 years ago, here it started. It was one of the first activities here in the polder. These buildings were built here and the establishment of the university. It was a university founded by the farmers, and it was also for the farmers to advise them and to produce more food, what was needed in that period. It was about 50 years ago, here this land was part of our school farm. Cows were grazing, potatoes and wheat were growing, but we had to move because citizens and the village was increasing, and therefore we had to move our farm to another place.
Social innovation, if you ask people the right question, they will come up with answers. And some of these answers are new, so they will renew society. But the most important thing is you need people who make the connection between a group of people and other groups in society. But one of the connections that you always need is the design function. People, very often within a group, don't have the proper skills internally to design, to draw the how they present a proposal, how they make it fit with the needs of other people that have to buy their products. And therefore it's very important that within this week that's just starting here, that the School of Agriculture, ARS, is also taking part in this and is taking initiatives, coming up with new ideas. Most often we think that social innovation comes from cities. This is a mistake because the connectivity in rural areas is a lot bigger. People know each other and they can reach each other. And therefore it's very important that a school of agriculture takes the lead in this type of thing and makes that connection so that people that are living in that neighborhood, working in that neighborhood, in small town communities, that they can connect to the larger world. Actually, social innovation is very simple if you think about it. It's all about making connections, talking with other people, getting to know other people, making connections. And therefore this forum is wonderful. Here you get to meet the people that hopefully this meeting today will carry on much further into the movement that we hope it will be.
I'm from the ARS Group and I want to tell you a little bit about a social innovation project that we recently started, and we have to learn a lot in that, so it's good for this team. And it's about reconnecting agriculture and civil society in this area. So the logic link between the rural community and food production has disappeared somehow. Of course we can separate function, but food is still a very important aspect of people's life, and they want to know how it is produced and of course whether it's safe. And we have to find out how can we reconnect citizens to agriculture. We need to produce more efficient, and we cannot afford to waste inputs. In the next few months we will interview all the stakeholders in the area and collect the different opinions and interests they have to see if there's some common values there, if we can co-create something, if there's a social enterprise to be, let's say, discovered, and they will have to deal with this problem shaping social innovation processes.
How to solve that kind of a problem? How to work together that we can create a new kind of a community which is not working for its own, but what's for us together. This is a non-profit organization where people with a limitation, physical or mental limitation, are working with animals, but also in this beautiful park. They produce all kinds of products and they sell it to the citizens. They have also a tea garden, so it's an integrated system of agriculture, taking care of each other, and production.